And we flew over to Haiti, and brother, sister, in 6½ days, that huge building was erected. All because God's children had a mind and a heart that was made up in their mind, and they were willing to sacrifice and willing to work for the glory of God.
Hallelujah.
Praise God. Today there's a plaque in that center with the names of all of these fine men that went there to build that center. Together with Brother Goforth's my name there, because we're the two fellows that really had the vision. And as God talked to our hearts and the Lord laid the project on us, together with many others across America, Brother Clyde Patton, he gave a good offering. And when Brother Freddie Neptune here was in Miami, Florida, pastoring a church at that time, he helped all he could. These other brethren, brother, that's the way that center was built. The government of Haiti is still scratching their head, wondering how in the world did they do it in 6½ days. Because it would have took the Haitians 6½ months to 1 year to do it. Same building.
That's not exaggeration.
Brother, sister, we call it the miracle building. The miracle structure, the medical center in Haiti. And some of you that are on the end know how that this church came to birth. While we fellowship together, these brethren got up in the morning at 5 o'clock. Some of them hit the kitchen and start slinging pots and pans. They cooked up the breakfast. 6 o'clock, they were out on the job. At noon, they came and had their dinner and rested an hour or so, and they were back there till 9 and 10 o'clock at night. That's how that building was built. Hallelujah. All of Haiti, the body of Christ, the people of God, and Brother Lee in particular, say a great big thank you to Brother Goforth, that they were the holy brothers to all of these other fine men that gave their time, their talents, and their labor to build the kingdom of God in the body of Jesus Christ on the island of Haiti. Hallelujah. We did this before, but let's give the Lord a big, big thank offering for having children like that. Hallelujah. One of these prayer reminders, a little book marker. It's not the best workmanship in the world because it didn't have much material work there. But there is a picture here of Brother Wilkinson and myself. And it says, pray for us, the missionaries to Yugoslavia. Please take one of these, put it in your Bible as a prayer reminder, or put it in your prayer closet, and remember to pray for us. Now, while we're laboring here in Tyler, Texas, we're doing this not because we don't have anything else to do, but because we feel the urgency. The time is short. I want to know that Jesus is coming very, very soon.
Amen.
And what we do, we must do quickly. And the church in Tyler, Texas, being pastored by such a great devoted mind that was willing to go to nations around the world and give his life in service to Christ because the love of Christ constrained him to do. And he brought him to the island of Haiti and laid a challenge upon him, and he accepted it. And then come all the circumstances, how that we fellowship not only around the natural table in Haiti, but we fellowship around the spiritual table in Haiti. The few nuggets of truth that were planted in the hearts of all of us there is what brought us out from behind the walls of Babylon into the fellowship of the body of Jesus Christ. You can't belong to Babylon and be in the body. Hallelujah. I mean, all of that.
Right.
No, sir. Brother, if you're in Egypt or Babylon, that's where you are. But the body of Christ is something altogether different. Tonight I'd like to speak to you just a few minutes. As the Lord anoints me and inspires me, I have no other motive for being here but to plant you deeper in the love of God and in the spirit of the body of Christ and in the divine order of the New Testament church. I believe that's the way it ought to be.
Huh? Amen.
That's right. I'm not here to exalt Brother Nick. I'm not here to exalt a human man-made name or system. I'm not here to carry some kind of a brand name or label. I don't have any hobby horse doctrines. But hallelujah, all I have to give you is He that is the way, the truth, and the life. He that said, I am the truth. The only way we can be the body of Jesus Christ is to be planted with the words of truth. Man-made doctrines and traditions and teachings will only separate us and divide us and create a bigger Babylon. But it's the truth that will make free from everything that man is building out here. In all of these rival kingdoms, they are fighting one another and have no fellowship and will not love one another. But tonight you see an actual demonstration of the body of Jesus Christ in action.
Amen.
Hallelujah. You see ministers here loving one another, working together, not for the glory of man, but for the glory of God. Hallelujah. Just think, we have lived and arrived at the time when the Lord is restoring three bodies in the earth.
Yes.
Number one, the body of Christ. Number two, the body of the beast. And number three, the body of Moses or Israel. Three great bodies in restoration today. The body of Christ, the body of the beast, and the body of Israel. These three great bodies are being built simultaneously. They're running neck to neck. God's not behind in the least. Everything is in prophetic timing. The Bible often says in due season. In due season, that means that when the time was due, God was on the scene of action in world affairs, doing what He was doing while the devil was doing what he was doing.
Yes.
Now tonight as we are here together, I don't want you to misunderstand me. I love God's people, God's ministry. I love the church. I love the kingdom of God. But I sure hate that which is dividing the precious people of God.
Yes,
and as long as there's a breath in me, I'll lift up my voice to God and sowing the seed in their lives that is not from heaven above.
Hallelujah! Yes, Lord.
You see, what is the body of Christ? The body of Christ is a body of people. It's a spiritual and a natural, physical body of people of whom Christ is the head, and His law governs this body of people. Hallelujah. Very simple, isn't it? Christ is the King of the kingdom, and that kingdom is ruled by the laws and principles that are laid down by heaven itself to govern and rule the affairs of the kingdom of God, which Jesus is the King.
That's right.
Hallelujah. That does away with all the man's works out here. I've got one scripture alone that will disqualify human man-made sectish religious denominations and organizations from being the body of Christ. One scripture, Jesus said, my kingdom is not of this world.
Glory!
Hallelujah, hallelujah. My kingdom is not of this world. While men are building their religious kingdoms out here, while are in this business of competition and rivalry between themselves. Well, they've sown a sacred spirit in their people, and they only love their own. God today is building the body of Christ, and it's a body of people that are feeding together, moving together, they're knit together in love. Christ is the head of this people, and they're laboring and working in the divine New Testament order. If you like it that way, say amen.
Yeah.
The kingdom of God doesn't have any man-made earthly headquarters. No, sir. The headquarters of the body of Jesus Christ is heaven itself. The throne of God, hallelujah, praise God. And the head of that body is the Lord Jesus Christ himself. And the body is governed in the divine New Testament order that Christ brought into existence and laid down in that early church.
Yes, sir.
2,000 years have come and gone, and men have done havoc with the body of Christ. It was men that tore up the body of Christ way back there in the beginning. Paul declared in Acts the 20th chapter and verse 27, 28, 29, and 30. He said, I am shown to declare the whole counsel of God unto you. But he said, know this, that after my departing, grievous wolves will enter in, not sparing the flock. And even of your own selves shall men arise, teaching perverse things to draw away disciples after them. I remember reading that in the Bible. As long as there was an apostolic ministry, as long as there were men of God that were taught by Jesus Christ himself, and he was their apostle, he was their teacher, he was their prophet, he was their pastor, and he wrote the law of the new covenant in the fleshly tables of their minds and in their hearts. Brother Jesus pastored that 120 people that came out of the upper room on the day of Pentecost. He taught that bunch of people that was his church, that was his body, that was his kingdom. Hallelujah. And they worked and operated in his name and no other name. And they suffered for that name. Because the Sanhedrin court, the Pharisees and the Sadducees, they got the 12 apostles, threw them in jail, and they said, we forbid you to teach or preach anymore in the name of Jesus. And Peter said, who in the world are you? Listen to your God. Heaven tells us to preach and teach, to speak in new tongues in his name, to cast out devils in his name,
amen,
to lay hands on the sick and kill them in his name. And if we drink any deadly thing and take up serpents, it will not hurt us because we're in his name and no other name. Somebody said, Brother Nick, what is the name of the body of Christ? Very simple. When Mrs. Bolt, when Sister Beaufort, before she was Beaufort, married Brother Beaufort, when they were married, she took on his name. Everything she does in the name of Beaufort, since she was married to Beaufort. And you know what Paul said, I have espoused you to one husband, that I may present you a chaste virgin of Christ. Yes. Brother, a virgin is a young maiden girl. A virgin is a woman that has never been corrupted and touched by man. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory, glory. And Jesus has the kingdom of body of people in the earth.
Uh-huh.
And he's the head of, he's the king of. Hallelujah. And I draw the door between him and the church. All giving divine order.
Come on.
But 1 Corinthians 11 chapter said that God was ahead of Christ.